Thank you all very much for joining this call. This is a historic day because we're all gathered to agreement in principle of the Canada-UK trade agreement. And I want to congratulate you, Mary, you, Liz. It's been a hard-fought thing. This is just, to an FTA that we're going to continue to work on in the course of the next year. But I guess what it means in the short term is British consumers will have greater quantities of Indian, maple syrup and dairy products and goodness knows what. More of our electric car and sparkling Brexit juice, as I think it's sometimes called, and goodness knows what else. Anyway, thank you very, very much to all of you. I think this is an incredibly important relationship. Justin, thank you. That you've done. And by the way, Justin, can I thank you also for your leadership in committing to net zero by 2050. That's incredibly exciting and important for all of us. And we look forward to working with you and with Canada as we go forward to our COP26 summit at the end of next year. Anyway, it's a great pride. Justin, how's it going for you over there?
Listen, Boris, it's just so great to see you. I know you're in isolation, but glad to connect with you at home. This is a good moment. We're all living with COVID-19, but there's lots of other things we need to get going as well. And the trade relationship and the historic relationship between Canada and the UK is just so deep that being able to make sure we're seamlessly transitioning through with this, that's right, the Canada-UK Trade Continuity Agreement, which is perfect to make sure that our businesses and yours continue to work well together. The UK is our fifth largest trading partner in the world, so making sure that we continue to do that. Yeah, it's a story. We will do much better than that. But you're our top trading partner in Europe, so at least
no pressure, Liz.
There's that we can still get to work on, and of course now we get to continue to work on a bespoke agreement, a comprehensive agreement over the coming years that'll really maximize our trade opportunities and boost things for everyone. And like you said, so aligned on opportunities for women and gender equality, on fighting for a cleaner environment, on things like digital trade as well. There are so many interesting things we're going to be able to do together. I'm really excited about it, but making sure that your businesses and ours were reassured as this important milestone comes up, that we're going to continue to protect everyone and keep 98% of the exports from Canada into the UK tariff-free and vice versa. These are the things that matter. C'est une belle journée pour l'amitié Canada, Royaume-Uni, et on va continuer de travailler ensemble sur ces enjeux.
C'est une belle journée.
Absolutely. Well, listen, I'd love to hear. I know, Boris, it's one of those situations where you and I get to, reap the attention. But we had Mary and Liz doing all the a tremendous amount of work to get to here, along with great teams of negotiators. So I'm happy to flip it over to Mary for a few words.
Well, thank you so much. Thank you so much, Prime Minister. Bonjour à tous. And it really is great to be here with Prime Minister Johnson, and great to see you again, Liz. And thank you both for joining us virtually from London for this important news. And it is excellent to have concluded negotiations for the Canada-UK Trade Continuity Agreement, a new chapter in the historic friendship between our countries, and one that will bring stability to our people and our businesses. And this is especially important in a time marked by uncertainty. And following the UK's decision to leave the EU and in turn CETA, we got to work. We knew that having an interim agreement would be crucial to ensure that businesses, exporters, our workers on both sides of the Atlantic have the continuity and that predictability that they need. UK, as the Prime Minister said, is our fifth largest trading partner globally. And in 2019, two-way merchandise trade with the UK amounted to $29 billion. So this means opportunities for our businesses and thousands of good jobs for people in both countries. Our new Canada-UK trade continuity agreement is going to preserve the main benefits of CETA, including the elimination of tariffs on 98% of Canadian products exported to the UK. And as we speak, our officials are preparing the legal text for signature, and we look forward to introducing and debating legislation in Parliament as soon as possible. This continuity agreement is good for Canadians. It's good for the people of the UK. It builds on our strong, mutually beneficial relationship. And our work doesn't end here. Liz, you and I spoke on Thursday morning, and we're very enthusiastic about beginning comprehensive free trade negotiations within a year of this TCA's ratification. We'll be working towards a high standard and ambitious agreement with a focus on women, the environment, small businesses, as well as the importance of digital trade. To our businesses and to our workers and all Canadians, these are unprecedented times. But know that amid the challenges we face, we will always have your back. We'll continue to work with our friends and allies like the UK to ensure that trade works for you all. Liz, now I'll turn this over to you.
Well, thank you very much, Mary, and it's fantastic to be here today with our two prime ministers. The deal that we've negotiated secures certainty for British and Canadian businesses, safeguarding tens of thousands of jobs. It's a win-win for two close allies and friends, and it maintains access to £20 billion worth of trade. It means continued tariff-free access for 98% of our goods, including things like cars, beef, and salmon. And if you look at the car industry, we currently export £750 million worth of cars to Canada, an industry employing 167,000 people. Mary, I'm incredibly excited about getting back to the negotiating table with you next year to do an even more ambitious trade agreement. We're agreed that on areas like digital and data, women's economic empowerment, and the environment, there's so much more that we can do together. Canada is a country that shares our values, a belief in democracy, freedom, and free trade. And I know we're also going to be working together at the G7 to promote free and fair trade across the world. Free trade is an incredible force for good. It's going to help us drive economic growth here in Britain and level up our country. And it's also going to help the world recover after coronavirus. This agreement that we've struck today is also an important step for our accession to the Comprehensive and Progressive Trans-Pacific Partnership, an agreement of 11 Pacific nations, including Canada. And it's part of our strategy to put the UK at the center of a network of trade deals around the world, particularly focusing on services and technology. It's vital to the global Britain vision, a country that is optimistic, confident, and outward looking. Mary and Justin, we have built up a great working relationship over the past few months, and we're very much looking forward to stepping it up in 2021. Thank you.
Thank you, Liz. Thank you, Mary, for all your hard work and your leadership. Boris, you know, the alignment, as always, between Canada and the UK on so many issues, from security to the environment to trade, as we're showing here today, is going to continue to be incredibly important in a lot of different ways. But of course, you and I are both headed to a virtual G20 in a couple of hours that will really dig into these issues as well, and this continued sign of our collaboration, cooperation, and deep friendship and partnership is really important, not just for people in our two countries, but people around the world as well.
Thank you. Listen, Justin, I just want to say that I agree very much with what you've said and what Mary and Liz have just said. Free trade is an important part of the way we're going to bounce back from COVID. But I also think that Canada and the UK share a perspective about building back greener, and using this as a moment in which to tackle climate change, but also to create hundreds of thousands of jobs in green technologies. And I just want to remind you, I think I told you before, when I, many years ago, or 12 years ago, I became mayor of London, and I had to put these hire bikes on our streets, you know, hire cycles. And we needed to find the best, most cost-effective, you know, they had to be a very chunky bike, but because we wanted to persuade people who weren't very confident cyclists to get on them and use them, and they've been a fantastic success on the streets of our capital. And you should know, and you may not know this, but you should know. We scoured the earth, we scoured the whole of the UK, Liz, for the best bikes we could find. Alas, by far the best ones were made in Canada. I think they were called Bixie, and they're still going. So it's green technology transfer across the Atlantic both ways that I think will help us. To bounce back stronger than ever. Listen, it's great. I'm delighted by what Liz and Mary said. This is just the beginning. We hope very much that we will be doing deals with you in the years to come that will enable us to be net contributors or net, we'll have the balance of trade in favor of us in clean green bicycles, which we also make. In the UK as well, you should know. Thank you all very much for what you've done. It's a great moment, and Justin, I'll see you in a minute in the G.
I look forward to it. Thank you, everyone. This is a good day for our peoples, good day for symbols around trade in the world, but practically really good days for our businesses. Merci beaucoup, mes amis. Thank you so much.
Bye-bye. Thank you.